Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. If you are new to this channel, then don't forget to subscribe the channel, and you can do that by press the subscribe button and, you know, press the bell icon so that you can get all the latest updates. So today we have a topic with us as the isError Excel function. Let's try and understand this function in a much more detailed format, as this is a information function in Excel, and there are various kind of errors. And you know, this is just one of them. There is a value error. So here is error function in Excel. You know, it checks, you know, if any given expression returns an error in Excel or not. Let's understand this in a very detailed format. If you just start with is equal to is error, it says you need to input a value. So value is what? So value is the expression or the value to be tested for error. And the value can be anything, such as like number, text, mathematical operations, or expression. It could be anything. Now there is a thing called returns. So the output of the is error in Excel is a logical expression. So if the supplied argument gives you an error in Excel, it returns the true, you know, otherwise, you know, it returns false in that particular regard. So for example, if it is given NA, that is, this is one kind of error, then there is a value error, then there is a color ref error, div zero error, then you have a num error, we have a thing called name error, null that is generated by Excel. So this is the function that returns true. Now, we'll try and do an example, like, you know, so that we'll have a good idea regarding what's going on here. So suppose you want to see if a number when divided by another number, whether it gives an error or not. So we know that, you know, the number when divided by zero gives an error in Excel. So let's check. Is equal to 21 divided by zero, it gives a div zero, right? And you know, it by using the is error in Excel. So to do this type of syntax, what you need to do is that you will say is error. Okay, open the bracket, then do 21 divided by zero. You will get a true answer, right? I hope you have got what we have done here. So what I have just done is equal to is error. Value is, let's say anything, 20 divided by 0, it gives us true, right? Now, it returns true. So, you can also refer to the cell reference in isError in Excel. Let's now check, you know, what will happen when we divide one cell by an empty cell. What? One cell divided by an empty cell. So, let's check this kind of a thing. So, is equal to, you will say, so you will say is equal to is error in that particular regards A5, this 29 as a value, let's say I am dividing with B5, it says true. Now if we just directly divide this, let's see what happens. It gives a div zero error, right? So what we are doing is 29 divided by the blank cell here. It gives a div zero error, given the cell B5 is empty cell. So the is error in Excel will return to as a true value. Now just close the bracket, you'll get answer true. Okay. You can also check if any cell contains error message. Okay. Like suppose a cell, you know, B6 here, contains, let's say, value error, which is actually an error in Excel, and you may directly input the cell reference in the is error in Excel to check if there is error message or not. Let's try that. You'll say is equal to is error, you'll say B6, close the bracket, it will say us again true. So the is error function in Excel will return to true. Now, suppose you just refer to an empty cell, let's say B7 in this case, and use the following syntax. Let's just simply say is error, and what you'll do is just take this as an empty cell. It will say false, right? You press enter, the is error in Excel is false. So the Excel is error function does not check for an empty cell, and an empty cell is often considered as zero in Excel. So as you may have noticed about that, if you refer to an empty cell in an operation such as like division, it will consider it to be an error as it is trying to divide it by zero, and thus it returns to a true value. Now how to use this is error function in Excel? See, the is error function in Excel is used to identify the cells containing an error, and many a times there is an occurrence of missing values in the data, and if further operations is carried out in such cells, then the Excel may give an error. Similarly, if you divide any number, let's say by zero, that's what we did, 20 by zero, it returns to an error. That's a div zero error. So such error further intervenes if any other operation is to be carried out on these cells. So in such cases, you can first check if there is an error in the operation. And if yes, you can choose to not include such cells or modify the operations later case. Okay. Let's go for example number one. Suppose that you have an actual and forecast value here, okay, of an experiment. So the value are given in cell B4 to C15. There's a forecast and actual. So you want to calculate the error rate in this experiment, which is given as actual and forecast divided by actual. So you also know that some of the actual values are zero, as you can see here, and the error rate for such actual values will give an error. So you have decided to calculate the error for only those experiments which do not give an error. So to do this, you may use the following syntax, like, you know, you'll be using something like this. You'll say is equal to if is error, okay, there's one bracket, you'll say this value actual C4 minus the forecast B4 divide by the actual C4, right, comma again C4 minus B4, okay, divide by C4 again, right? I hope you are getting it, what I'm trying to do here. So once you do this, you get this answer, and just pull, drag this down, you will have the answer for the rest. So you may drag it to the rest of the cells and you will have this kind of a structure here, right? So you'll realize that when the actual value is zero, cell 9, the syntax returns to no value. Now let's see for different syntax, you know, how does it exactly changes based on the forecast and the actuals, right? So by far now you must have got a really a great idea regarding how to use the is error function. Now there are some of the things that you should know about is error function. See, is error function in Excel checks if any given expression returns to an error. Now if it returns the logical value as either true or false. Now, you know, if it the tests are like NA value ref error, div zero error, num error, name error, and there are things called none error. So I hope you have got a fantastic idea regarding how the whole structure works in is error function. If you have learned and like video, please don't forget to like the video, and please don't forget to subscribe our channel by clicking the bell icon. Thank you everyone for joining the session. Cheers.